The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Friends, we have already made a lot of videos on many important medical health topics, giving you authentic, verified information, all referenced from US National Medical Library, so you can trust the information. To find a video of your concerned topic, just type the topic name with Dr. Education on YouTube search bar and you will find a video on it. Now, today we are going to talk about fungal nail infections, right? When fungus attacks your nails, what happens? Basically, fungus grows in and around your fingernail or toenail, basically. So this can happen because fungus can actually live in dead tissues like hairs, nails, and even the outer skin layers. And it's very common to have fungal infections like athlete's foot, jock's itch in your pants, and fungal ringworm infections. Yes, ringworm is also a fungal infection which can happen anywhere in your body, even in your head. So fungal nail infections often start after a fungal infection in the feet, and they occur most often in the toenails and then in the fingernails, right? And they are very, very commonly seen in adults as they age, in the older adults, right? You are at higher risk of getting a fungal infection if you are a diabetic, because fungi basically, they easily are attract in immunocompromised diabetic patients. If you have peripheral vascular diseases in which the blood supply of the of your limbs are compromised, peripheral neuropathies, the nerves are compromised, if you have minor skin or nail injuries, if you have deformities, deformed nails, or there is a nail disease already present, if you have moist skin for a long time, if you have any immune system problems, if you have a family history of this kind of fungal infection, or if you wear a footwear that does not allow air to reach your feet, then you have high chances of having fungal nail infections, right? Fungal nail infections. So what will happen? Sometimes symptoms. See, there will be nail changes on one or more nails. Usually the toenail is involved, and the changes would be something like brittleness. There will be change in shape of the nail. There will be crumbling of the outer edges of the nail. The debris will be trapped under the nail. There might be loosening or lifting up of the nail. The thickening of the nail can happen. The outer most luster or shine which is there, it will be lost of the nail. There might be white or yellow streaks on the side of the nails also. These can happen. So you need to go to a doctor to get it diagnosed, and a doctor, a dermatologist, will just look at your nails and tell you that it's a fungal infection. Normally diagnosis is confirmed by looking at a nail scraping under a microscope, and this can determine the type of fungus also. Samples can be sent for cultures also, which may take 4 to 6 weeks. So before even the culture comes, over-the-counter medication, creams, treatments, you can start off without any prescription, right? So these treatments will help you get, control and even get rid of these medicines. Even prescription medicines are available, which you can take from by mouth. Oral the counter creams and ointments usually do not completely help treat the condition. That's very important to understand. So the treatment, usually over the counter creams and ointments are usually, they do not help treating a fungal nail infections. So prescription antifungal medicines are needed, and they will help you take care of the fungus, and you can take it from a dermatologist, and then you will need to take the medicine for about 2 to 3 months for your toenail and shorter time for smaller fingernails. Your proctor will do a lab test to check for liver damage while you are on these medicines, because such a long-term medicine can cause liver problems. So remember, fungal toenail infection is not a small thing. Laser treatment may sometimes also get rid of the fungus in the nails, and this is less effective as compared to the medicines. But of course, in some cases you may need to have the nail removed also, so you need to go to a dermatologist. Remember, the fungal nail infection can be cured by the growth of a new non-infected nail, and the nail grows slowly. Even if the treatment is successful, it may take up to a year for a new nail to grow. Therefore, you need to be patient. And fungal nail infection may be hard, a difficult thing to treat. Medicines can clear up the fungus in about one half of the people who try them only, right? Even when the treatment works, the fungus can return back. So it's very difficult to get rid of a nail fungal infection. That's why you need to talk to a doctor as soon as possible. If your fungal infection, if you feel there is a nail infection, if the nail, a finger, or your nail or finger is getting painful red, or if there is an additional superimposed bacterial infection, right, then that will have, even pus can happen in the finger. Prevention is possible. Good general health hygiene can help prevent a fungal infection. So what you need to do not share your used tools which are used for manicures or pedicures with others. Keep your skin clean and dry, especially your foot and the places between your toes and fingernails. Take proper care of your nails. Wash and dry your hands and feet thoroughly after touching, or and especially after touching your nails or fungal infection. This nail fungal infection is also called onychomycosis, tinea. Tinea ungulum, or a fungal infection basically. So this is all about a nail fungal infection, which you need to know. So definitely you need to share this information, because a fungal infection can actually spread from person to person. So if you're coming in contact with someone who has a fungal infection in the foot or the nail, then it's possible you might get it. If you're going for a shower in public places like a swimming pool and all, still you can have this kind of infection. So it's important for everybody to know about this. Therefore, share this video. All right, I'll see you tomorrow. Stay connected, stay healthy.